Hello, dear students. This is A.P. Gupta, your English faculty. And now we are going to start online classes. I know very well, in this corona pandemic, you are at home. And this is a very important thing. So, stay at home and be safe. Now we are working hard for you. We are going to start online classes. So, get ready. As we know, the book first, Honeysuckle. Lesson number one. Who did Patrick's homework? This is a question mark. Exactly, who did Patrick's homework? And writer is Carol Moore. So if you have a book, so open your book, lesson number one, who did Patrick's homework? Before you read, discuss in class. Do you like homework? Do you do it yourself? Or do you get help? What homework do you usually have? It's me. Some homework have been given by the teachers in your class. So you are to complete your homework with carefully and you are to revise because you are to become a perfect student. So paragraph number first, Patrick never did homework. Too boring, he said. He played hockey and basketball and Nintendo instead. His teachers told him, Patrick, do your homework or you won't learn a thing. And it's true. Sometimes he did feel like an ignoramus, but what could he do? He hated homework. Now here, first word meaning is here Nintendo. Nintendo means a video game which is played in mobile or a computer. And basketball, you know very well. That's next word meaning is ignoramus. Ignoramus means an ignorant person who lacks education. Means we can say what is not about any education, that is called ignoramus person. So what is the meaning of first para? Patrick is a student, he is studying in class and he doesn't like to do any type of homework which has been given by the teachers in the class. And every students are here to get feeling like a bored because they don't like to do this type of homework. Okay, so Patrick always like to play like basketball, Nintendo and hockey, but he did not like to do any type of homework. So teacher always says, Patrick, if you want to do any type of homework, so you won't learn anything, and if you want to learn anything, so you will have to do homework. Okay, next step. Then one day he found his cat playing with a little doll and he grabbed it away. To his surprise, it wasn't a doll at all, but a man of the tiniest size. He had a little wool shirt with old-fashioned breeches and a high, tall hat, much like a witch's. He yelled, "Save me! Don't give me back to that cat! I will grant you a wish. I promise you that." So, according to second para, it is being said here. One time, Patrick watched what his little cat was playing with a little doll. But when he looked carefully, so he recognized that is not a doll, that is a elf. Elf means, you know, a small and tiniest size person, that is called an elf. And suddenly, when the cat grabbed the elf, so elf cried and speak. If anybody will save me, so I will grant his wish. If anybody has any type of wish, so I will fulfill his wish if he will save me from this cat. Okay, so now paragraph number third. Patrick couldn't believe how lucky he was. Here was the answer to all of his problems. So he said, only if you do all my homework till the end of the semester, that's 35 days. If you do a good enough job, I could even get A's. It's me. Patrick has a wish that he has. Firstly, Patrick saved him. And he told him, if you will complete my homework, so I can save you. What was the wish his? His wish was that you will have to complete my all types of homework. If you will complete my all homework, so I will get A's. A's means A grade here, A grade. Okay, as we can say like 90% upside. But you will have to complete this homework at the end of the semester and it is approximately 35 days. Paragraph number 4. A little man's face wrinkled like a dishcloth. Thrown in the hamper, he kicked his legs and doubled his fists, and he grimaced and scowled, and pursed his lips. Oh, am I cursed? But I will do it. Who said? Little elf. Little elf said. Firstly, his expression was changed. His expression was totally changed. What was the changes in his expression? First, he wrinkled. His face was wrinkled like a dishcloth thrown in the hamper. So what meaning first? Wrinkled. Wrinkled means shrink. Shrinkness in on your face. So dishcloth means which cloth has not been used for the proper work, or we can say as the cloth which is used for washing anything or cleaning anything. Thrown is the third form of the verb throw, threw, thrown. And hamper. Hamper means a basket with a lid. So his face was looking like this cloth, wrinkled, this cloth, and thereafter he kicked. Kicked means his leg kicked by forcibly in the aggrieved. Thereafter he doubled his fist, means like this is palm, when you will double it, this is a fist. Okay, and then grimaced, scowled, and pursed his lips, and lips also, he changes his lips movement also. Oh, am I cursed? But I will have to do, because if Patrick will save me, so I will have to do, because I have promised him, if you will save me, so I will wish your grant. Next para. Okay, my dear students, next para will be continue the next video. Thank you.